Hi everyone, and welcome to this 90-minute yin yoga class. This routine is designed to just shut the world out for a little while. If that's how you're feeling, I'm definitely feeling that with you today. So I thought we would just do a really quiet, really relaxing 90-minute practice. This will be a mostly silent class. I won't be talking. I'll just tell you what pose we'll be doing and how long we'll hold it for. We'll do some nice long holds for this yin routine. Most poses will be 5 minutes in length and some will be 3 minutes. I'll be using some yoga blocks and a bolster. If you don't have a bolster, don't worry too much, but you might just grab some blocks. Even one would be fine. And if you don't have blocks, you might just use a thick book or something that could replace a yoga block. So let's begin in child's pose. We'll hold it for 5 minutes. you can pick yourself back up, slowly coming to a seat on the mat. Staying here for 1 minute. Come into sleeping swan now, having your right knee forward. We'll stay there for 5 minutes. slide back into crocodile pose now for the next minute. Extend your left arm out to the left and roll into broken wing for the next 3 minutes. You can come back onto the front of your body, resting in crocodile for 1 minute. you can make your way to sleeping swan again, this time with your left knee forward. Once again, you can slide back into crocodile pose for 1 minute. Extend your right arm to the right and come into broken wing for 3 minutes. Come back to crocodile pose for the next minute. Now we'll come into Anahatasana or melting heart pose for 3 minutes. Slowly make your way up into a seat on the mat. From here, we'll come into dragon pose with the right foot forward. You can come into whichever version suits you best today, and we'll be here for 5 minutes. Now you can make your way to shoelace pose by walking this right foot over towards the left. Sitting on your right hip and then bringing this left foot all the way across. Once you're settled in shoelace pose, you can incorporate eagle arms as well by reaching your left arm out, bringing the right arm in underneath. We'll keep eagle arms for 3 minutes. You can release eagle arms now. Find a shoelace twist by twisting over to the left for 1 minute. come back to center now and find a shoelace bend by reaching your left arm over towards the right side of the room. We'll come back to center. Unravel your legs and do some windshield wipers for the next minute. We'll make our way back into dragon pose now, this time with the left foot forward. Holding here for 5 minutes. we'll transition into shoelace pose now, bringing your right knee on top. Once you're settled, incorporate eagle arms by reaching your right arm out first, left arm comes underneath. You can release eagle arms. And now come into a shoelace twist, twisting to the right side. Come back to center and find a bend over towards the left. Come back to center, unravel your legs, and do some windshield wipers. From here, we'll come into 3 minutes of dangling pose. You can release dangling pose and come down to lie on the back of your body. From here, come into happy baby pose, and we'll hold it for 3 minutes. Release happy baby now and rebound in corpse pose for the next minute. We'll practice supported fish pose next. So you can place a prop in underneath your chest. You might rest your head onto another prop. There's an option to bring the soles of your feet together here for reclined butterfly pose. Or you might want to elevate your knees with a bolster or a cushion. We'll stay here for 5 minutes. You can slowly come out of the pose now, removing your props and then lying in corpse pose. We'll stay in corpse for the next minute. From here, we'll come into banana pose, stepping the feet to the bottom left corner and reaching your hands to the top left corner. We'll stay here for 3 minutes. You can transition to the other side now. You can come back to the center now. Do whatever you're called to do for the next minute. Now you can unfurl into corpse pose, where we'll stay for the last 4 minutes of our practice. Bring a little bit of awareness back. If you're ready to do so, you can come sit on the mat again. We'll close out this 90-minute yin routine with 3 breaths together. Thank you so much for joining me for this practice. Personally, I feel a little bit more ready for the world again after doing that. So thank you so much for joining me. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please let me know by leaving this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you're not already subscribed. I would love to practice with you again in the future. I have a lot more silent yin yoga practices, just like this one. So check those out. And if you would like more of this style of video, let me know in the comments below. I'll see you again soon on the mat, but until then, take good care of yourself and goodbye.